Today, we are back in Blender. We're gonna be working on doing some rigging, and gonna do some animating and some weight painting. So yeah, let's get into it. I feel like I remember. Oh no, we did get that to work. Okay. Cool. So, where I think I'm gonna start today is with weight painting this little robot guy. Actually, I might do some modifications to him first because I'm not totally crazy about all of this design stuff. So maybe we'll start with that, and then we will begin. Thanks, Claire. I think so. I just deleted. I last time I had used the grease pencil to draw a little face on him, and drew a face on. Something happened. Are we still streaming? Weird. What's going on? Okay, suddenly I'm on a Mac. I was on a PC a minute ago. And now I'm on a Mac. So, yeah, I don't even know how to stop the stream right now. Okay, bear with me for a minute, everybody. Is happening. Oh, there's a button to press between the two monitors. It switches between the Mac and the Windows computers. Okay. Let's see. It'll maybe press this button and we'll see what happened. There's a button. It's on a little box. Hey, there we go. Okay, we're back. Thank you, Librarian Claire. I don't know how that happened, because I definitely didn't push it before, but now I know how to fix it if it happens again. Okay. So yeah, welcome back. I'm Jeff. I'm from the and, oh, it says that I'm Jillian, but I'm actually Jeff. From the VR lab at DH Hill on the NC State campus. And we're building robots. So I'm gonna go back into object mode, and I was starting to say this before, I'd used the grease pencil last week or a couple weeks ago to give this guy a face, and I'm not using my drawing tablet today, so I think I'm gonna do a face a different way. I'm just going to build it right into the character itself. We're going to model it. So let's do that. I'm going to tab into edit mode. And I had done some. There's enough Jillian to go around. We're all a little bit Jillian. You can't gatekeep Jillian. Yeah, I'm not sure if I can fix that while I'm live. So, just know that Jillian gets the real credit for being Jillian. Okay, so I'm gonna shift space, control R. Nope. Now I'm gonna do that. Shift space, control R. It's gonna get us loop cuts, you know, my favorite tool. And I'm just gonna make like a really robotic looking mouth for this guy. And then shift space B and get us back into selection. We're gonna do 3 to select faces. I'm gonna select all of these. So there are probably too many lines here, but that's okay. We're gonna go over here. My mouse is getting stuck. And I'm gonna just extrude this in. It looks funny now, but it'll look normal in a minute. And then it's doing something funny with the shadows. I'm not sure what's up with that. But then let's gonna go to our materials. I'll just make that. Yeah, the lighting is funny there, huh? Oh, it might be because I'm shading smooth. Yeah, shade flat does a little better. Okay, we'll keep it shaded flat. And then I'm actually gonna start a new object. I'm gonna shift right click to bring my cursor, the 3D cursor over there, and we're gonna make like a little like grill mouth. Like I feel like in like Futurama and shows like that, they always have that like weird robot like grill for a mouth. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna go up here. Click a scale. Did it again. I'm back in a Mac. I think it might have something to do, like if I press shift a bunch of times, it switches, which is hard because I do press shift a lot. But it's okay. We know how to fix it. Is very strange. Okay, so that's like our weird robot teeth. Scooch this like a little bit. What I'm gonna do now is set up an array modifier. So we can just go over here to array and start, you know, how much we wanna space these out. Set this to 0. Well, that's pretty good. Sure, and then I can just apply that array. And there you go. Homie's got some teeth, and I'm gonna space command. Oh, no, we gotta edit. space, control R. Loop cut, shift space B, select faces and extrude. Oh, you know what might be a more efficient way to do that? We could just go back to when you were an array modifier, and then we'll do that there. Go back to edit mode, loop cut. Select the face, extrude. Oh, is the array modifier still? Now we can do that, okay. You know, the nice thing about messing up a lot is that you end up getting really good at certain tasks because you have to do them like 6 times. Why are you not working? Does it apply the modifier when I modify the object? Ooh, that's interesting. Curious. Okay, let's go. Okay, I thought this was going to be more efficient, and I learned a valuable lesson. And that's that this is definitely not an efficient way to go about what I'm doing. Nice. Okay. Now we'll apply. Can't do that in edit mode. Go back to object mode. Apply. Lock this face and extrude. I don't know, it's something. It's whatever. We'll give him what. Thanks, mod. Looked a little better in my brain space, but here we are. So what are we gonna do for eyes? I'm like roughly moving around something that will become a funny little robot eyeball. We'll duplicate that with Shift D. Bring it over here, bring it down a little bit. Go to grid view. Yeah, that's not overlapping too much. All right, sure. Okay, let's make you a different color. New material, make them a little bluish, maybe. So then, I don't like that color. Maybe they do need to be the same color. Yeah, whatever. That's fine. Okay, so goofy little robot. And we're gonna go back to that weight painting that we were talking about before. So, gonna select the rig and then shift select the. Oh, I gotta parent these first. Nope. I could just join them. How do I do this? I wish I'd done this before I added a face before I added the armature, because the armature makes it a little confusing. Okay. Hopefully I didn't break everything. Yeah, okay, cool. Now moves. So we're gonna select both of those things and go into first I'll show you what I mean, why we're doing why we have to do weight painting. So I'll go into pose mode. If I grab this and rotate, you see how I gotta get in closer. You see how it really deforms the arm? It changes the shape and sort of bends this rectangle to make that movement happen. And same with if I also select here. You know, you get kind of similar stuff. This cylinder sort of distorts. We don't want this, especially, you know, if you had a realistic human body, you would have similar but different problems where the part of the elbow bends that isn't supposed to. In this case, it's going to be really easy to weight paint because I want it to look robotic. I mostly just want a lot of things to not move at all. So we're going to go back into object mode. Weight painting. And you can see, it's funny that I have this bone selected and this is an area that's coming up hot. It shouldn't be like that. So, I'm going to shift, is it control click? Control click on this bone, and with this bone selected, I can, I have been doing this in the newest Blender and it's a little different on this slightly older one. But I think it should pretty much work the same. Oh, there's some stuff I gotta do first. With my brush, gotta do some stuff with my brush. There we go. Okay. If I can remember what tab it's supposed to be under. It's probably fine. Okay. Something I'm supposed to do involving not. There's some other setting I was supposed to turn on, but we're just gonna see what happens. So with the weight painting, it's mostly looking for vertexes in the mesh, and that's sort of what it applies the quote unquote weight to. You can see as I paint this, it's getting this a little bit, and we don't want that, but we can go back and fix it later. And you'll also notice it kind of actually changing the shape of the mesh, because once you take away ownership from a different bone, it basically sort of like reconfigures how the mesh works. So we're gonna control click here. And you see there's like funny amounts of ownership with this bone. So okay, make it so this bone owns this whole joint. Like another one of those tasks that I know people hate and find really tedious, but is actually borderline therapeutic for me. There's something I'm not getting right here, and I don't know why. There we go, we did it. And here, this one is pretty good. It does have a lot of ownership over this arm. Should have turned on X mirroring, but I didn't. So now we can all. Okay, and this is gonna be, I think it's my last stream for the semester, so I'm hoping that I'll get to keep doing this next semester, but so I have a different version of this that I've been working on kind of at home. I like to practice before I come in. And I actually like that robot like a little better, so maybe I'll swap that one out at some point. But I was just talking to a friend and he was like, "Well, just you should just make it into a game." And I was like, "Yeah, that's sure, like you got to start somewhere." So I think that's gonna be part one of my winter projects. I'm gonna make a couple more robits, and then I was thinking it would be like a beat 'em up racing game, like a little Mario Karty. Awesome, Claire. That's exactly what I want to hear. So yeah, like I don't know, basically a knockoff Mario Kart, but it's got cool robots instead of your favorite Nintendo characters. I think that's what the people want. But like more less racing focused and more like beating up your friends focused. So you see up here, one of the things I'm doing is basic. Oh, nope. Oh no. Not that. Oh Lord, what have I done? What I was trying to say is this. This weight thing right here, it took me a while to figure out that this is how it worked, but you pretty much just want it at 1 or 0, because like at 1, we are adding weight, Right, but then if you wanted to take it away, you could just put it to zero. And I guess you would want some stuff in between, because if you were doing like an arm or something and you wanted this to only move a little bit in accordance with that bone, then yeah, sure, I guess that makes sense. But for my purposes, one or zero. Go to zero just to clean this up. You know, my brush is too big. This is what the problem is right here. Nice. Now we can go tap back into object mode. Make sure those are select our armature. Go into pose mode. Let's just see if that worked. If I rotate here, no deformity. Rotate here, still some deformity. Okay, let's see what I did wrong. Maybe it just always will have a little bit of a pull. But at home, I got it to go a little better than that. Okay, yep. Sure enough. Did it again. Wow, did I just not do this one? Like, what went wrong over here? Oh, wrong button. Think that's pretty good. It's not perfect, but it's fine. This is a low poly game about robots. Shouldn't get too hung up on the details. Yep, that's pretty spot on. See, how do I? Got my bone properties. Or maybe it's in my. What I'm trying to remember how to do is to get it so that the bone shows on top of the mesh, so it's easier for me to... There's some other things I wanted to turn on. Ambient occlusion is good for better light. Screen space reflections. It's definitely going to make this run slower, but it looks prettier. Rendering in Eevee. In front. There we go. Now we can see the armature. Yeah, I was thinking I might sell it for their next short. He's got spunk. Okay, and this is easier now, so we'll control click here. Yeah, we want more. All of this stuff. These parts are important because it's like you just don't want, like, if the head turns and the body deforms in any way, it like breaks the illusion. And I'm gonna go. Click here. Yeah, that's way off. We don't want that. Don't want the neck to touch that head. Okay, I'm getting bored of weight painting. I'm trying to wrap this up so I can move on. That's fine. Oops. That's kind of fun. It's not what I wanted. Dang. I didn't think that through very well. Okay. That's confusing and isn't what I thought it was going to do. Does it make the eyes so weird? This is not what I want. Very strange behavior. Okay, I'm gonna have to come up with a different solution. Maybe they do need to be on their own little face bone. So that. So that something. Okay. Let's go like this. That's all messed up now too. Oh, but in edit mode, it's. Okay, y'all, I'm gonna take a quick five and get some water. And when I get back, we'll either figure out what I'm doing wrong with this face, or we'll move on to something else. All right, thanks. Be back in a minute. Okay, we're back. Wondering, so when I go to edit mode, these are in a different spot. I wonder if I can. Nope. Space G, set them back into place. See, now I'm just confused. Okay, what I'm gonna do is go back. Here. And I'm just gonna split these off. Here, your own object though. All part of the armature. Side view. You should be split now. Separate. Selection. Okay. So you are no longer a part of this armature. Go back into object mode. Great. Parent, no. Why? Oh, this should be so much easier. I'm not used to making things with working faces. The type of thing I'm doing, I don't really plan on having this move that much. If I parent you, then you disappear. That's why. Oh, you know what? Take you and this is the thing, this always trips me up. This might work. I might have nothing to do with the problem, but I'm gonna go Command A and we're gonna apply all transforms. And that should make that more stable. We're also gonna do it to you. Okay. And then we'll try parenting again. So weird. Okay, well, it is following this around, so that's a start. Okay, cool. That's probably not the right way to do this, but it does seem like it works. And now maybe we can go to pose mode. Dang. Just want to parent that to that joint. It's kind of fun though. It just sort of like doesn't really follow. Okay. Okay, well, I'm frustrated with that, so I'm going to move on. And let's just make another robot instead of doing this, because it's driving me nuts. This one's fun and is going to need a big face, and apparently I am not doing a good job making faces, so I'm not going to worry about that right now. Instead, we're going to come over here. Move our 3D cursor there. Oh, I like how that ground looks. It's kind of rough. Okay. Oh, it seems to be. Oh, if I double tap the middle mouse button, that's what's making this switch between monitors. So funny. Oh, maybe I could turn hotkey off. Cool, that seems to work. So okay. That's not something for the audience, that's just something for me and the streaming lab. I figured out how to make it stop switching computers. Okay. Okay. We've got two robots. Let's think about the next robot. Maybe it's like a dog or a. I need like a shape. The one's like person shaped, the next one's a ball. Let's just make another person, but make it like different and goofier. So we can go similar with it. We'll go. What if it's got two big wheels and like the robot part is in the middle of those two wheels? So we'll make. So we could start with this. We just do Shift D, move it on the Y plane. And shift space S, scale the whole thing down. Cool. Go shift A. We're gonna add. We'll add a cylinder here. We'll make the radius a little wider. The depth really short. We'll go 90 90. Eyeball what the center is here. Okay. Seems like kind of like a, almost reminds me of like a chariot or something, is what I'm seeing here. So let's go edit mode. Gonna do this to inset faces. Do that a couple times. Selection lasso. Get all of these faces, but not you. Yeah, it's kind of a cool shape. Ooh, and then we should go and set another face and extrude it inward. Nice, I like that. And on this side, we'll do the same thing. Shift D along the Y axis. And then shift space R. Hold control, it snaps. Perfect. And then I'll do actually I should wait on that. So there's like our spoke, and we'll make our little dude like float in the middle. Rotate it along X 90 degrees. And then like so. Shift space, command R, cut that, and we'll go into our wireframe, select all of these faces,
Delete.
I actually wanted that cylinder to be its own object. I thought I fixed you. There we go. And I'm gonna do And this is why you should always build things at the world origin, because now I'm trying to do a mirror modifier and it's not working. Because it doesn't know that I'm way off to the side. I end up with stuff like that. Just not what I want. So this person's just gonna be a little bit uneven. Not the end of the world. That's fine. So then I'm gonna a couple more loop cuts here. And I always forget how to do this, but it's so useful. I want to snap these faces. Onto the, I think, X axis. Or maybe it's Z. Because I want to flatten them out. This might be a Google situation. Okay, internet, what do you say? There are two types of snap operations. First snaps your selection to cursor. Shrink or flatten? No, I guess what I should do first is maybe I want this to be a little wider of a selection than that. I'll go. just extrude down. And now I'll try to strange function. Woo. Okay, that didn't do it. I'm just not going to worry about it. Okay, so that, and then we'll stretch just a little bit and up the scale. Yeah, why not? There's its head. Somewhere I gotta squeeze some arms in. I think they all need to have arms so that they can robo battle. I'll just stick them right there. Thank you. It's not really like a not awkward place for me to put arms on this guy. That's fine. We'll lean into it. Just, he is who he is. Say we put him on the outside, but that seems weird. All right, he's got two goofy little arms. Keeping these wheels separated so that they can like spin and stuff. I'm not sure how I'm gonna do that, but. Thank you. The metallic makes it less cartoony for me, so maybe I'll. Okay, let's rig this fool. It's gonna be a funny one. Selection to cursor. Now we'll control A, now apply all transforms. Cool. Okay. Let's make an armature. wonder if I can mirror this. Whatever. Let's do it twice. Okay, let's see what happens here. Object mode, select both of these things, and we will formature deform with automatic weights. Pose mode. And if I nothing. It's just the order that you select stuff. There we go. Whoa. Yeah, this one's real goofy. This is a good example of that weight painting thing, where like I want to move the arm and it doesn't know. That's pretty fun. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna have to go back to our good old buddy, the weight painter. Thanks, NCSU Libraries Mod. I'm glad you think so. Okay, yeah, there's our problem. There's your problem. Let's make radius wider. Arm doesn't move that stuff at all. Let's try hitting this and going back into pose mode. Oh no, it's still doing it. So there must have been something that I missed with that weight painting. It's definitely not as dramatic as it was. Okay. Yep, some down here. Zero. Yeah, maybe I guess I should just shouldn't have, when I did the armature, I shouldn't have selected automatic weights. I bet that's why. Man, you are giving me a run for my money here. I guess we'll have to rebuild it or reattach the armature. Anyway, only 3 minutes left. That's gonna pretty much do it for me. I'm gonna see if I can fix these things and maybe start to build a game over the winter break. I hope that everybody else has a great time and a great little stretch of being off. Get some relaxation done, work on some different skills than you normally do. And I don't know how much the VR lab is going to be open over the break. I'm not actually sure if I'm doing anything there or not, but it'll reopen, if nothing else, it'll reopen as soon as the semester starts back up, and we really hope that you come visit us. We have some really fun stuff planned for next semester, and it'll be open the same hours that it has been every day, pretty much. And yeah, I've had a fun semester streaming with you all, so looking forward to doing it again.